Bledsoe was arrested.
Patrick Montgomery was in court.
Jonathan Manapa will stay in federal custody.
No, I don't take responsibility at all.
Hey everyone, welcome to the show. So 38-year-old then Virginia resident Jessica Bustle had posted on Facebook prior to the Capitol attack, and she said, quote, "We don't win this thing sitting on the sidelines. Excited to stand for truth with my fellow patriots and freedom fighters in DC today." She had traveled to DC with her husband Joshua, and they were seen on surveillance video illegally entering the Capitol. They headed straight to the rotunda, and Bustle and her husband were inside for about 20 minutes before a large group of officers arrived, and then they forced everyone out of the room. At that point, the Bustles exited the rotunda, they exited the building. Following the Capitol attack, Bustle posted again on Facebook, and she said that Vice President Mike Pence was a traitor. Bustle incriminated herself and her husband by saying, quote, "We stormed the Capitol." And then in another post, she said, quote, "The amount of misinformation I'm seeing is insane. Despite what you're being fed, the rally was nothing like what the media is portraying. When we finally decided to head over to the Capitol, we were let in. Like, literally, my husband and I just walked right in with tons of other people. Yes, some Trump supporters were supposedly unruly, pushed past police to take selfies in Congress seats. But seriously, members of Congress reassembled in the same place that was supposedly destroyed. People were simply making their presence known, finally growing a backbone. This election has been undermined and stolen. People are tired of being lied to and cheated. We need a revolution. We can accept an honest and fair election, but this is not fair. And patriots don't want to see their country brought into communism and destroyed over a lie." Yeah, we don't want to see everything destroyed over a lie either. Anyway, Bustle was arrested on March 8th of 2021, and she was charged with entering a restricted building or grounds, two counts of disorderly conduct, and parading or demonstrating in a Capitol. In June of 2021, Bustle pleaded guilty to the parading charge, so she was looking at up to 6 months in prison, 6 months of probation, and $5,000 in fines. The government, though, requested only 3 months of home confinement, 3 years of probation, 40 hours of community service, and $500 in restitution. Ridiculously weak, and Bustle even has a previous arrest for disorderly conduct. But the prosecutor said that Bustle immediately acknowledged her guilt, that she wanted to resolve her case as quickly as possible. So U.S. District Judge Thomas Hogan presided over Bustle's case, and at the sentencing hearing, he said that she and her husband experienced, quote, "substantial punishment in regard to their relationships, basically on a social level." The judge also acknowledged that Bustle was remorseful, but he told her, quote, "Your statements about patriots are so inaccurate, so misguided. Patriots are not ones to attack those trying to complete their constitutional duties and attempt to stop it." And Hogan said, quote, "Seriously considered putting you in jail." And then he also called out Trump's election fraud lies. He said, quote, "Here we have a group of individuals irritated and misled by false claims of a fraudulent election, trying to take the law into their own hands." And he was a Reagan appointee, so, you know, not some lib. In the end, Bustle was sentenced to 2 months of home detention, 2 years of probation, and $500 in restitution. So pretty weak sauce, especially considering who the judge is. Like I said, he was a Reagan appointee. He was typically very tough. He definitely has no love for January 6th or what took place that day. And seriously, home detention, don't threaten me with a good time, right? I mean, unreal. And Judge Hogan allowed Bustle to delay her detention, not even, you know, an arrest, but just detention, because she was moving. She and her husband moved to South Carolina. They said, oh, we need a fresh start because of all the fallout from January 6th. I could have sworn these are the people who said, fuck around and find out. You know, facts don't care about your feelings. They sure have a hard time with the find out phase, right? Anyway, I'll let you know if I hear any more. This, just so you know, this was one of the older sentencings that I'm just now getting to that slipped through my fingers, slipped my attention. So I'm backtracking and trying to get some of these older ones taken care of so that there's a complete and full record of all of the January 6th sentencing. So if you're saying, you know, this is an old one, Gina, this didn't just happen, you're right. It didn't. All right. Thank you all so much for watching and listening. Please like the video, share it, become a subscriber if you have not. If you can donate or leave a one-time tip or a super thanks, it's greatly appreciated. Love you all. Take care. Talk with you soon.